sure you keep William on a tight rein, Robert.
Ranger, for horses?
Not necessarily.
Are you sure you'll be all right?
It's only for 2 days, Mother. Now do stop fussing. Look, send my best wishes to Uncle Alan. Bye-bye.
A record of your behaviour while they're away. 3 black marks, and I'll make you polish all my shoes for months. I saw that. Black mark number 1.
Wait a minute, they're not supposed to be fighting each other.
Look, I'm King Arthur and I make the rules. Attack!
Many belated happy returns. Better late than never, I hope.
Oh, Sheila, you've forgotten. A hairbrush! It's just my boy's watches.
Well, I remembered how much you admired the one I gave Father, so I bought an identical one for you.
It's just the best present there ever was. I've never seen anything so wonderful.
Listen, it's only a brush.
Well, certainly it's not. It's ebony. It couldn't be more perfect. Do you know, I was beginning to think that you were about to give me the old heave-ho. You found me foolish, even. Well, I think a thank you kiss is in order, don't you?
You ever get used to having an earthquake as a brother?
No, you never quite get used to being. Now, where were we?
I should be going.
I thought we might play some gin rummy.
Oh, Robert. Don't you ever long for excitement, adventure? To live life to the full, travel the 7 seas.
Oh, yes, actually. I'm going on the Conservative Club out in Cirencester.
How utterly thrilling.
Sheila?
There's no need.
At least let me give you a lift there.
And get oil all over my dress.
Well, I see you tonight.
Father's taking me to see Swan Lake at Sadler's Wells. With the ballet.
Oh.
We're staying overnight in London.
Tomorrow, then?
I don't think so. Au revoir, Robert.
Robert! Quick! William!
Usually is.
Quick!
You can and all. Keep still, Master William.
Ow!
Ow! Ouch! Glassed thing cut my thumb.
Best run under the tap, Mr. Roberts. You are a complete menace, William.
That's nice, I must say. What with me being injured and everything.
You being injured? What about me, huh?
And it was you that drove Sheila away.
That is black mark number 2 with a vengeance.
One more black mark. I have to clean all of its shoes for a whole month.
My brother's always telling me off too. And mine's a bigger otter than yours. And he's soft in the head. Guess what his favourite birthday present was?
A hairbrush given to him by Sheila Baron.
Maybe it's a really special brush.
It isn't. Her father's got one just like it, he said.
Pretty much all potty, if you ask me. Things they give each other make me sick. I mean, honestly, what's the point of birthdays at all? All you get is not an old handkerchief and ebony hairbrushes.
What is ebony, anyway?
Wood, silly, from an ebony tree.
I've never heard of an ebony tree.
You haven't heard of anything, have you? It's a special, precious wood, and it's black, and it's called ebony.
There's no such thing as black wood.
There's jolly well it is.
Bring it in, then, so we can see.
Come. Robert would never let me touch it.
Don't take it out of the house.
See, told you there's no such thing as black wood.
There is.
I'll bet you my second best catapult.
Your best catapult and a quarter of pear drop.
Okay.
Done. Fire! Robert? Robert?
Up to, Master William?
Nothing. I just thought I saw a squirrel. I chased it up here, but I can't seem to find it anywhere. You haven't seen it, have you, Ellen? No. I better hunt it down before Jumbo has it for dinner. Excuse me. See? Ebony. Black wood. Some Smagsicle or someplace like that.
All right, you win. But I bet it's not from Africa. I'll look it up tonight.
Looks pretty ordinary to me. Your brother must be bad to make such a fuss over a brush.
Don't you know anything about grown-ups? Not the brush, it's the girl. Sheila Bowen.
Catch, Henry.
Give it back.
What if I don't?
You'll get a ducking in the river with all your clothes on.
All right, catch.
Hey! Hey! Careful! William, careful! Come on, William, quick!
Hey! You boy!
Come on, William!
Turn off your stubborn thing!
William, quick!
Come on, William,
come on, William, quick! Come on! William, careful! William, careful! William,
what is the
afraid of him?
I'll see about that! Get off!
Fisherman's day up all night sometimes. He can't go back till tomorrow at the earliest.
Well, but bound to know if his brush is missing by then. It's all Douglas' fault.
You dropped it. It's not my fault. You're a rotten catch.
Wait. You said Sheila's father's got a brush just like Robert's, and the Barons are away.
So?
So all you have to do is get old Mr. Baron's brush and swap it for Robert's till Robert's is dry.
And how am I supposed to do that, Clever Cloth?
No, now up it.
Or I'll call the police.
Sorry!
Got it. Well done!
Uh-oh!
Clear up, you scallywags, or I'll have your butt for garden! Are you?
Caught you!
I can explain!
Don't bother! I'm one step ahead of you, as usual. You think you can pinch my notebook and I'll forget about your black marks, hmm? Well, you've got another thing coming. Now go away. It's giving me a headache.
Yes, Robert.
Wait till I catch hold of you!
Scratch on it, thank goodness.
Ebony, that little wood from the Diaspora's Ebonus. A tree that grows in India and Ceylon. I told you it's not from Africa. I've got a good mind to take my catapult back.
Stop being such a squat.
Can I have a go?
No. It says it's brittle, like chalk. You might snap it.
Me? It was Douglas who threw it in the river.
Well, I didn't know Ebony breaks easily, did I? Tell you what, pick it up by the bristles, then there's no chance of you snapping it.
That's all very well, but I've got to switch it to the one in Robert's room now. Been asleep all morning with a headache.
You can't wait all day. What if Mr. Barron comes and wants to brush his hair?
I know. Why don't you burgle Robert's room? In disguise in case he wakes up.
That's the most stupid idea I've ever heard.
I've got it. You sneak in and get the brush, and I'll stand guard over old Robert. And if he wakes up, boom! I'll knock him out before he can see who it is.
That's the second most stupid idea I've ever heard. Well, have you got a better one?
What are you doing?
Morning, Robert. We were just...
Just what?
Just wondering if you'd like to play cricket.
Oh, go away!
Do we have to stand on guard?
Yes, in case the gun or someone comes while William's burgling.
I'm not burgling, I'm putting something back. That's the opposite of burgling.
Doesn't matter if you get caught then, does it?
All right, you do it.
No fear, it's your brother's brush.
If you don't get a move on, that grumpy old gun will come.
Come
on, come
down
the drive. Come on,
you two.
Go on.
Oh,
who's
there? We are here after night. You're not allowed to enter.
Go on, go on. Off with you.
King Arthur had Excalibur. You only had a hairbrush.
Why are you always such a wet blanket? Let's get this. Stop!
Honestly, Debbie, they're terrible.
Absolutely minutes.
Oh, Mr. Barron. Mr. Barron, thank heavens you're back. I went into Miss Sheila's bedroom to do my dusting, and there it was, gone.
What's gone?
Miss Sheila's jewelry. It's been stolen.
Poor Sheila. Was no one hurt?
Not so far as I know, sir. The Baron's maid just telephoned to say there'd been a burglary while the house was empty and...
Hey, where are you going? Can I come?
No, none of your business. You stay out of trouble till I get back.
Hey,
broke a pane of glass in your veranda and then just put his hand in to turn the key.
Never of you.
Sheila, well, is there anything I can do?
Robert, I hardly think so.
Who is there, Sergeant?
Our main clue is the fingerprints found on Mr. Barron's hairbrush. You can see the thumbprint quite clearly. It looks like our man injured himself recently. You see that mark? Some kind of cut.
Fascinating.
Well, fingerprints don't match anyone else's in the house. So, chances are they belong to you-know-who.
But why should a burglar brush his hair in a house he's come to rob?
Father, sure.
Working for the criminal mind, sir. Impossible to fathom. But it's usually one slip like this that gives them away.
How utterly brilliant.
Well, I'd better make sure he hasn't taken anything else.
But what was stolen exactly? Everything on this list, sir.
May I? Yes, I've read about cases like this. The thief will sell his swag on as soon as you can. Now, I intend to scour every jeweller's in this area, and I'll not rest until I have recovered everything that is rightfully yours.
Robert, do stop trying to be heroic. It doesn't suit you.
Thank you very much, sir, but I think we've got everything under control.
Sheila, I will be back with your jewels. It's the last thing I do.
It's quite the most thrilling thing that's happened since we moved to this dreary little village.
Well, I suppose that is one way of looking at it. Good afternoon.
Oh, honestly. That wretched motorcycle. Why, Robert Brown. You sly old thing.
Robert, a burglar? Has he cut his thumb recently?
I don't think so.
Yes, he has. On that saucepan he had stuck on his head, remember?
That wasn't a saucepan, that was King Arthur's helmet.
That proves it. Robert's thumbprint matches the one at the scene of the crime. Oh, this is too thrilling. He's not as dull as Ditchwater after all. He's a master criminal, like Raffles with a Scarlet Pimpernel.
You seem very cross about your jewels.
Life is for living, William. I'd trade a few jewels for a bit of excitement any day. How clever of Robert to go searching for the swag. I expect he's fleeing the country even as we speak.
No, he's having a nap in the garden.
Oh, honestly, Sheila, do I look like a master criminal?
I don't know. I've never met one.
Be reasonable. If I just pulled off a jewel robbery, I'd be catching a train out of here, not catching 40 winks.
But it might be a cunning alibi.
I didn't do it, Sheila. Cross my heart, hope to die.
Oh, Robert, you're such a disappointment.
Yes, we thought you were like Raffles or the Scarlet Pimple.
Oh, shut up, William. Sheila, I am not a criminal.
Well, if you didn't do it, then the real robber's still at large on the run.
I hadn't thought of that.
Bet your gardener saw who it was.
I doubt it. Father dismissed him last week.
I saw him whilst I was passing your house the other day.
Probably came to let his things.
Well, he might have seen something, I suppose. We should go and ask him.
Can't be talking about. As far as the police are concerned, if they match your fingerprints to the ones at the house, then you're the man they want.
But I'm
he
not...
must smuggle you out of the country under a cloak of dark on a midnight boat to France. We must prove you're innocent.
Oh, will you listen? I am not a burglar.
Explain your fingerprints, then.
I can't.
Precisely. So it'll be your word against police evidence. Do you want to go to prison?
Look, no, I suppose I could hide out for you somewhere. It would make you happy.
That's more like it. Well, follow me.
Oh.
It has to be the cold slip. It's filthy in there.
I'm surprised why the police would never think of looking at
you. I'll go along with you on one condition.
Which is?
You come with me on a Conservative Club trip to Cirencester.
I can hardly wait.
Lock me in here. William! Sheila!
Thank you.
gone, Lily?
Our ex-gardener, yes.
He's in. I saw the curtain move.
We have to do this.
You're not scared, are you?
No, but he did say to have your guts for darters. Maybe he's not in.
The curtain moves.
Maybe he's deaf.
Maybe he's gone upstairs.
Maybe we should go home.
Coward!
I am not. All right, prove it. Look in through that window and see if he's there.
Why should I?
Because I'm King Arthur and I command you. And you must say yes, my liege.
King Arthur?
Yes, Knights of the Round Table. You can be Guinevere if you like. Henry is meant to be Sir Lancelot. And he's not very brave.
I'll look through that window, but I'm not saying yes, my liege.
Go on, then. Your gardener was horrid, but fancy him being a thief.
Yes, why? My father sacked him, so he took his revenge by stealing my jewels.
I really think we should fetch some grown-ups.
Don't be daft. Sir Lancelot didn't just go round fetching grown-ups, did he?
No, but I'm not Lancelot. I'm Henry.
Look, this is rather serious. I'd better go and tell father.
All right, we'll make sure he doesn't escape. Come on, then.
We'd like to see Mr. Robert Brown.
Well, I'm afraid he's not at home.
Well, you won't mind if we take a look for ourselves, will you?
Henry, Douglas, guard the front door. Me and Jim will set you duty here. Catapults at the ready.
We haven't got any ammunition.
You two, go around the front. Come on, quick. Come around.
He's seen us. I'll have the law on you stealing my eggs.
Oh, no, you jolly well won't.
Oh, won't I indeed?
No, because pinching jewels is much worse than pinching eggs.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Ready? Aim. Fire!
Will that be Mr. Robert Brown?
Yes, it is. Who's that?
Oh, I've been stuck in there for ages. Look, you came along.
Well, you'd be used to being locked up then, won't you, sir?
I mean, what's going on?
You see? Light as rain.
Of fussing and worrying and all for nothing.
Well,
I told you Robert would have it all under control.
Robert! What's going on?
Is this your son, sir?
Yes.
What's he supposed to have done?
Ask him!
Hello? What's going on?
William, tell the police I'm not a burglar.
Of course you're not. Mother, father, welcome home. William? William? My jewels!
You wonderful boy.
Is there a reward?
Yes, there most certainly is. There. Thank you very much indeed.
William!
What the devil is going on?
You see, it was all Robert's fault, really.
You say such a thing!
Because it was! And for your silly old ebony hairbrush falling in the river, I never have gone towards Mr. Barron's house, and that was when I saw the gardener, who we thought was digging up plants, but then Sheila told me he'd been dismissed. We went to see if he knew anything about the jewel robbery. We had to stand guard while she fetched the police. He tried to escape, we pelted him with eggs, then we captured him and got him on the ground. Tied him up, put him in a wheelbarrow and brought him here. Then I met up with Sheila, gave her jewels back. So that's why you should arrest him, not my brother.
There's show-stopping stuff next on BBC One with John Nettles, Anthony Newley and Luther Vandross.